It must be obvious to a lot of you know that our great Celtic heritage has been robbed over the years of a lot of its tunes by other countries less well endowed than ourselves. By that I mean that other countries have taken our tunes, put their own words to them, and claimed a lot. America in particular, in fact, has been one of the main perpetrators of this kind of nonsense. So tonight we'd like to kind of redress the balance and bring back to this country one of the old tunes that went overseas, and we'd like to sing the traditional Scottish words to the old tune. We were very lucky to get these words from Mr. Bill Hill, who himself is a fund of knowledge on folklore, so our thanks is to him. A man came riding out the west one wild and stormy day. He was quiet, lean and hungry, his eyes were smoky grey. He was lean across the herdies, but his shooters, they were big. The terror o' the Hieland glens, that was a Portree Kid. He drum ho, he drum hey. The chuchter that come frae sky. His sidekick was an orra man, and oh, but he was mean. He was called the Midnight Ploughboy, and he come frae Aberdeen. He had 27 notches on his crummock, so they say, and he killed a million Indians way up in Stornoway. Portree put it in the door, he sauntered tae the bar. He poured a shot of crabbies, he shouted slangevar. While midnight was being chatted up by a barroom girl called Pam, who said, "Well, howdy, stranger, would you buy a baby sham?" Now over in the corner sat three men frae Achter Tool. They were playing games for money in a snakes and ladders school. The fourth man was a southerner who'd come up from McMerry. He'd been a river gambler on the Ballahoolish ferry. He drum ho, he drum hey. The chuchter that come his sky. Portree walked to the table and he shouted, "Shake me in." He shuggled on the egg cup, he gave the dice a spin. He threw 7 sixes in a row and the game was nearly done. But then he landed on a snake and finished on square one. The game was nearly over and Portree was staying fine. He'd landed on a ladder, he was up to 49. He only had but one to go and the other man was beat. But the gambler coped the board on and shouted, "You're a cheat." Men dive behind the rubber plants to try and save their skins. The accordionist stopped playing, his sidekick dropped the spoons. He said, "I think it's funny you've been up that ladder twice, and you always done the table when I go to throw my dice." He drum ho, he drum hey. Ha, ha, ha. The chuchter that come from the sky. You okay?
Fine.
The gambler drew his ski and do as fast as lightning speed. Portree grabbed a screw top, he cracked him o'er the heat. Then he gave him Laldi with a salmon off the wall, and he finished off the business with his lucky grouse foot's claw. Portree walked up to the bar, he says, all hey, a half, and you like the way I stuck it on that wee McMurray Niaf. But a southerner crept up behind, his features racked with pain, and he gupped him way an ashtray, made out a curling stain. The fight went raging on all night till opening time next day. A break for soup and stovies off a coronation tray. It was getting kind of obvious that neither man would win when came the shout that stopped it all. There's a bus trip coming in. Sing this song in Gala Shields and up by Peter Heed, way down o'er the border, across the Rio Tweed, about what became a Portree Midnight and the gambling man. They opened up a gift shop, selling fresh air in a can. Fiscal.